wake up. Before we go to the next problem, I want to give you the general theme, the general pattern for all these problems that we have. So, and until I say that we can stop to do them, all the problems that I will give you will be solvable using this pattern. Я сейчас объясню общую, она уже более-менее понятна, еще общую схему, как устроены эти задачи, общую структуру. И пока я не скажу, что мы уже пришли к другим задачам, все задачи будут решаться по этой схеме. Ну, не всегда это очевидно, но в принципе это так. Okay, so the general scheme is as follows. We have some problem, and it is reduced, ее можно свести, the following situation, that we have two sets, the set A and the set B, two shapes, two figures, plus образуют две фигуры, and we must find points X and Y, point X on the set A, point Y, such that not only the points are belonging to the set, but also we have some transformation F. Transformation F that takes X to Y. Задача сводится к такой, что у нас есть две, ну, по-моему, две фигуры, а их бы, и нужно найти точку на одной фигуре, точку на другой фигуре, с таким условием, что одна точка приходит в другую при некотором известном преобразовании. Но оно в задаче не дано, само преобразование, но мы должны понять, что это преобразование и условие задачи. This is the statement of the problem. And how do we solve it? We simply take this transformation, apply it to the set A. This is F of A. And take the intersection point, and this will be Y. So the solution can be written by one formula. Решение можно записать одной формулой. Y belongs to the intersection of the set B. And the set F of A. This will be. Who understands what I have said? Who understands? Okay, everybody. Very good. Very good. So if we look at this problem number one, what are the sets A and B in this case? Что будет множествами A и B в этой случае?
Points X and Y here.
A
Poet says, now what transformation takes X to Y? Какое преобразование переводит X в Y? It must not depend on X and Y. Just some transformation defined by the statement of our problem. То есть преобразование не должно отрицать зависимость, конечно. Оно просто определяется в условии задачи.
Но вот эти точки А, Z, центр from point A, it's minus one.
And the point. другой. Там уже мебель цельная. And we have to draw a square, which this point is one of the vertices, and the other two vertices are on the side. The other vertices are this and this. And this is the fourth one that we really need. So this is a given point, x, y. Do you understand the question? So
yes.
This problem easily fits on our pen. Эта задача легко ложится на нашу схему. Because we really have to construct two points x and y, and we have to set where these points belong. The only thing that we don't know yet is what is the transformation that takes x to y. How would you describe this transformation?
Rotation by
90 degrees.
45 degrees.
45. 45 is close. But if we rotate a point at, okay, let's look at the square, which is, well, essentially, по существу, the problem is not about this circle, the question that we are answering. This question is about a square. So if I take a square and I take one of its vertices, and then I take a second vertex, x, and the third vertex, y. And I want to understand what transformation, if there is any transformation, takes x into y. У нас есть просто квадрат, которого фиксирована вершина O. И мы берем следующую вершину и следующую. И мы хотим понять, какое же преобразование переводит x в y. You have to understand that what are we given? We are given a point which can any square for which it is a vertex. So this can be another point, x1, and this would be its image, y1. And of course this is not a translation, because if you have two points, just two points, then there are infinitely many transformations. It can be a translation, it can be rotation by some angle, it can be light reflection, whatever. Two points do not define the transformation. The transformation is defined by the entire construction, by this square. So what would you have to do to take x into y? No. Why?
Dilation.
What factor? So in dilation, points are on the same line, aren't they? O, x, y, and to take this, we multiply O, x by some factor, k, and we get all the way, right? So here, x is here, y is there. What would you suggest to take x into y, so that x1 at the same time is taken to y1, and for any other square it also must not. Maybe some new transformation. Maybe some combination of transformations that we know. Also, with combination, it is not going to be possible.
Why
is
it
What line do you suggest? Midpoint. But we don't know point x. What we know is only point O. If you take another point x, you will have another line. There will not there is no one information defined this way. Это то, что ты сказал, не определяет преобразование, оно зависит от тебя. Для каждой точки ты будешь свою ось подбирать.